decorating and was on the internet, spraying it all. They're all staff. You start off with the system preparation, you know, surface preparation, and you know, you move on to different systems, you know, and it's easy for me. I find that quite easy. The things I used to struggle with is when I used to work for big companies and they give you snagging lists and you give you lists as long as that. And obviously all these lists, all these snags, all of the system. So that of the system, that of the system, and you just, I don't know, sometimes they were overwhelming because you couldn't do that until you've done this system and you've got this long list, and but I suddenly worked to a list. To start off with, you have to be open, you have to say, look, yeah, I'm autistic, you know, and there's certain ways I can, certain things I can do, certain things I can't do. And it's not that they've been awkward on purpose, it's because they can only do it one way and they have to do it their way. If you don't do it their way, then it can cause meltdowns or lack of, well, I mean, for instance, for me, if my routine got changed dramatically, or even a little bit, really, to be honest, it's dramatic for me, then I'd probably just go home. So if you don't manage that person correctly, then you could lose 3/4 of a day out of it. You know, it's management and being open about being autistic. And it's difficult for some people. An autistic person has lots and lots of information, and you might find who's a person autistic, I'll ask lots of questions. I mean, when I pass a job up, or photos, can you park? You're asking so many questions because you need all that information to make sure that you're going to be happy doing the job. There's nothing, I can't turn up onto a job now where I don't know what I'm doing. That's the only flaw that autistic people do have, is they have obsessions. And that obsession overrides, you know, the cost of things, and, you know, or, I mean, my obsession, I have had one person, one autistic person might stick to one obsession all the time. It's the autism that, it controls you. It controls every minute of your life, from getting up in the morning. It's, you're a clock watcher, you know. And that's another thing about an autistic person. They're loyal and they stick to time limits. You give them a time limit. You know, this has got to be done for in 2 or 3 hours or whatever, or you've got to get this done. They'll work from, well, I used to work from night to get jobs done. And sometimes when you actually open the customer time, then you can see sometimes think, that's why he's like he is. And you know, and then people just think, all right. Because, you know, my communication skills sometimes are bad. You know, I don't want to talk to me, and I'll leave the phone. You know, and this world now, you said things, texting, emails, it's ideal for a lot of autistic people. But it allows them to hide as well at the same time. The skills of an autistic person, in the right atmosphere, you know, well, they're really, really flourish. I mean, and yeah, if you've got a person that likes the job, I don't even know what the money is. Yeah, I've done jobs before, and I wanted to do that job so much that who cares how much I